you want to be pretty close on your transport temperatures, it can be crucial to how long your product will hold. So we use the thermal blankets when we're transporting it. If we got broccoli and cabbage, so we can keep the temperatures at, you know, 35, like broccoli and cabbage should be transported. We got cucumbers and peppers, we use those blankets to keep them at, you know, in the 40s like they should be, mid-40s to 46, 47. That way the products are stored correctly. Humidity plays a big factor in broccoli and cabbage on storage.
Staging the product. We're pulling all the Whole Foods pallets out of the coolers and making sure that they are accounted for and box counts are taken.
We got a full truck today, 26 pallets. So we'll actually be loading them on what we call pinwheeling. Pinwheeling, so one pallet's gonna go in like these are setting over here, straight towards you. The other pallet will be going in long ways. Every other time you'll rotate, the pallet that's long ways, you'll want to snug it up against the wall. The one that's going to be straight, you want to snug up towards your other pallet. You'll rotate each time on which side you're loading on, and you're going to gain about 6 inches for two pallets loaded. You can get about four more pallets per truck that way. When you're loading the truck, make sure you get your pallets tied in really well. Not only side to side, but up against each other. That's going to help keep them from shifting on the off side where they're not against the wall. That's a big thing. If at all possible, make sure you load your tallest pallet in the front. That way, if your driver does have to stop really hard, it's got something to fall up against and not going to go flying everywhere. Forklifts do tend to kind of slide on the water. The steering's kind of delayed a little bit, so you know, you can't pull out very fast, it'll spin out, and it's slick. I mean, if you're using a pallet jack, the trailer will get pretty slick. You know, you gotta be careful with that too, and definitely make sure you use load locks and get it secured in the back really well. I'll show you how both kinds of load locks work. For Dale's trailer, we always use this top. It's just fastened into these grooves on the side of the trailer. That's kind of out there. Pull it right here before I leave back on it. Let's just stop and help.
Yeah, I got
it. What does it take? You're stuck to put that up snug against that on your pallet. Take the excess. So not all the trailers are going to have these grooves in the sides where you can hook in that type of load lock. On the ones that don't. Like that. We'll also use those when we got pumpkins or something that's, you know, we got two layers of. Pumpkins and anything that's in a bin like that, we can load too high as long as we have a lid in between the two sets of bins. So if we get 56 bins of pumpkins on a trailer, like I said, we use this type of load box to lock them in, to where we can put them up higher to cut down on the risk of them falling over. When you're doing a truck-to-truck, we've got a metal dock plate that's portable that we use. You'll back the trucks up within just a couple feet of each other. The dock plate will lay down in between the two truck beds, so it'll barely lap over each one, and that'll allow you to transport a pallet with the pallet jack from one truck into the other.